Okay, it's April 11th, 2019. It's 9:20 a.m. Oh man, the garden hasn't, nothing has been done for the garden yet. I've got three different types of sunflower seeds here. This is the large heads, the ones that get to almost 2 feet large. No, this one here, the smaller bag. The seeds are even bigger, plumper looking. I got three different types of sunflowers here. I've already planted the ones that are black seeds, you see, looks like the ones for cardinals, for bird seed, black sunflower seed. I planted those on the east, what I call sunflower wall, wind wall, about 2 weeks ago, kind of early. And I'm letting grass grow in there with it as long as I don't overtake it. There's no sunflowers coming up yet here. I might plant some of these in with it too. But this one here is only about 20 feet roughly from south to going north. This is on the east end of the garden. See, I don't see no sunflower coming up. Oh, right there. Actually, I just said that, and then right there, there's a sunflower coming up right there. This is Sony, so if it shuts off, you'll know why. All right. Anyway, it's the black seeds sunflowers. Well, see here, I tilled all these up about 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, and I just pulled the loose soil and the grass and everything into a hump down the center. This is about 62 feet. I'm standing at the east end of it. That's north. And see, this is Monsanto's winter wheat growing. In June, they're going to be harvesting this crap. So any deer that come out of the woods over there could get killed in the field, you know, the baby deer and all that, because that's been known to happen. Because, you know, Monsanto, yeah, you gotta have that toxic food-like product. So I'm gonna put seeds down in here. There's none in here yet. Just, like I say, just on the east wind, fence, whatever you wanna call it right here. And then I should have had some peas planted, but we can't really eat peas on the keto diet because it's got sugar in it. Sucks too, but, you know, like I said, planting some beans over here. But right now I'm gonna get these three different types of sunflowers, and we're just gonna put them about maybe 6 inches apart, down about 3 inches, 2 to 3, about 2 inches, I should say, about to my first digit. Can't really show you on here, but it's the first digit on my finger. Can't hold the camera with one hand and have flat seeds in one hand and try to record. So, but yeah, I think you can just see the grass all through the plastic out here. This was tomatoes that we let get root rot in it. Had cantaloupe and watermelons and cucumbers all down here. Watermelon just took over. Watermelon and cantaloupe, actually, from that southwest corner all the way across this garden. So this year we're gonna do, can't have those either because of sugar. We might grow one plant. I don't know. We'll see what that goes like for the summer. On keto, I'm lost so much weight. My shorts are I can close my shorts off. I mean, fasten them. And then I can pull them straight down right off of me, over my hips and everything else. That's such a, I mean, for people that don't realize it, that's a really cool feeling. I'm like, check this out. I button on my pants and I just tug on them and they go down to my knees, to my ankles. So that's, you know, cool. I was out at 250 pounds, almost 100 pounds overweight. Now I'm down to around 220. Roughly 24 pounds, 224, maybe 220. I didn't weigh myself for it until Saturday. But, I mean, the weight's coming off. Need to do more exercise and get out. I can't really do anything when my knees are bad. I've got a treadmill upstairs. I can get on that at least and slowly walk for at least doing half hour up there in the attic. That's the windows I'd be looking out. The treadmill's real close to that up there. I can look at. Well, it's not, of course. It's in the middle, facing long ways, you know, from that way to that way, and I look off to my right and I look out those windows. But my elderberries out here, put this mulch down there. Look at how the leaves are coming on this. This is the second year I put them in here, in late summer last year from Stark Brothers. And then this one here, that was transplanted. That was sitting close to where Lucy is right there. It's just growing up. And we, right there it is. We can see the dirt. We dug that up with a shovel carefully. And then we put it here and put some mulch around it. And it looked like it was going to die. I put water on it. And look at it. It's coming back now. So if that one takes off, cool. There'll be three elderberry bushes out here. See this one too, look how full it is. The only thing is I have to find netting to put on top here that'll help keep the birds off it, and I'm hoping it'll cut down on the beetles. Because, you know, when this thing starts blooming, we'll have berries on this all over the place, three of them. And just try to keep the birds off them from eating and then going around and pooping everywhere we have. And then the fireplace, we still need about 12 more stones. It should only be like around 3 high, but I'm going to make it 4 high. Because we dug down in there and we just made this. This I did by myself on my own. I didn't look at anything to do it. I saw round ones in the past and I just did it myself. So I'm not cementing it. Because, you know, we don't live here. We're not going to live here permanently. And I thought, well, it'd be questionable. Depending on the circumstances, when we move from here, I might want to just take the stones with me. Or I just leave them like this. I mean, I'll finish it, of course, do it 4 high. But get about 12 more stones, I think. 12 to 16 more stones to finish it off. And it's supposed to rain late tonight. So if the winds calm down, maybe later today, with these two chairs that are about broken, we'll get the chairs off the front porch. Sit out here and burn the fire for a while. It's supposed to be real windy though, that's the downside. So this has been out here for 2 years, and we sat out here 3 times, 4 times maybe. And here's wood we had brought over here with grass growing through it, because it was just, you know, blocking all everything. This is gonna get burned off. We got firewood underneath that tarp, you know, pieces of tree trunk and big branches and such. So, but we're gonna use this little, this is a lot of this is pecan wood from the pecan tree, and it's got really nice, cool smell. It kind of almost as good as oak, or hickory rather, almost as good as hickory, but smells good when it's burned, but it burns kind of quickly. So when we get that going, this probably late this afternoon, early evening, around 5 o'clock, 6, if the winds die down enough. See, that's another thing. I usually put string and pieces of cloth around handles and let them sit like this, so I can see like a little wind gauge out here that's coming out of the south, blowing north. You know, the flags on the front porch, you can see the same thing, but see, I go from one thing to another, There's the fire pit, there's the elderberry, and then Lucy and CJ's graves. I'm going to put a torch sunflower. I'm going to try planting a couple of seeds for torch sunflower, the big, pretty orange ones that get the hummingbirds and the big large-winged butterflies and honeybees right here, closest to CJ's grave. I was going to do that over here, but like I said, I'm going to have sunflower. This is the west sunflower fence wall, whatever you want to call it, going from south to north. And I'll maybe put a torch or two right down at the very end here, and then regular sunflowers the rest away, and then along the back. So I have a big U. Just basically almost across right here is where the other one started. Before I had it all the way up to the front. Same thing over there with that. I'm going to put the torch sunflower for CJ. I had a space between the graves here, and then I went out over there. I'm just going to stop here, and I basically did the same over there on the east end. So it's like a U, but to block it off, mainly from the main reason for that originally was to keep the overspray and crap from the Monsanto toxic food-like product. You know, we're surrounded by that, 360 acres of that crap. It gets into the well water. I have a big Berkey water filter, which does filter 100% of the glyphosate, which most other filters don't. They might filter up as much as 60 or 70%. You better check it. But, you know, if you're not going to do what you need to do to stay healthy, then you need to just shut up. Don't laugh about it. Don't say anything. Just shut up. Roll your eyes. Look in the mirror and go, ooh. So, we choose to try to eat as healthy as we can. Monsanto is not, I repeat, is not part of our choice. We have no chance to do anything about this. It's not our property. We don't have the income to move somewhere else. We would move in a heartbeat. But if the opportunity ever does arise for one other reason or another, you won't see anything from me for a few months until I get myself situated and settled, and then I will give you an undisclosed location where we're at. But pretty much, we're going to do the same similar things that we're doing here. I'm actually, with the money available, I would like to have this whole area cut up, taken with us, and put down on the land wherever we'd be. And a lot of people might even laugh about that or scoff about that, but you know what? There's a thing called morals and integrity. I have them. Some people, majority of them, don't. So, but anyway, I digress. Yep, there's your Monsanto poisonous, toxic food-like products surrounding us. Most people don't even give it a second thought, laugh about it. Oh, what are you going to do? Exactly. You know, take a loaded gun and put it up to your temple, make sure there's a bullet in the chamber, and squeeze the trigger almost to the point. And what are you going to do, right? And there you go. Anyway, this will be peppers and tomatoes. We've got a bunch of them growing in the house right now. Number one will be peppers and tomatoes. And there'll probably be a couple torch sunflowers. I don't want them real close like they were last year, right on top of the plastic. When they start coming up so high, I'm going to transplant them. This time, for sure, we're going to transplant them in a very reasonable way. Out of the 140 garlic we got out here last year, out of 160 that we're planting, we got more that are just growing back. We're going to let them continue to grow, maybe. We might put some onion down here. You know, plant some onions inside and then put them out here in this little area in the middle. And that part back there, I was going to join these gardens. Again, this all sounds easier than people think. I mean, I have a bad knee right now. This one was replaced, but it's sore as hell. This one is overdue, but, you know, can't afford it right at the moment. But, you know, just, I was going to join all three of these gardens and just leave this section like this for onion and garlic, maybe. Pepper and tomato over there, some peas and maybe beans over here with mom's old frame, swing frame, to go onto it. And in the back, like I said, with the keto diet now, it changes a lot of things. You can't eat everything that you think you could. It's not saying that it's really bad for you, but you're not going to drop weight and you're going to increase your sugar. And let's see, diabetes is on the rise. I wonder why. Look at your loaf of bread. See if there's sugar in it or not, or fructose or fructose or any of that stuff. It's sugar, starch. But you know what? It's too much. I know. I just want to go to Walmart and get the stuff because it's cheap and I can eat more. I mean, I can feel better about myself. So, you know. If it wasn't for ignorance, this country wouldn't even exist on the planet right now. Lucy, get up from there. Stop that. She's rolling in the grass. But just wanted to show you. I started out here, coming out here to show you about the sunflowers coming out here at 10:30 to start planting them. Got those over there. There's one growing at the far end over there on the northeast end of the eastern wall of sunflower. And then that'll be the northern wall all the way across to help prevent the damn overspray. After they harvest this winter wheat, I have no idea what other Monsanto product they're going to do. I think, if I'm not mistaken, I was told soybeans, the number one most toxic, most chemically induced product that you can eat, let alone manufacture. I'm not going to say grow, it's manufactured. That's not growing, that's manufactured right there. It's all genetically modified. Is soybean. Right after soybean comes corn, then comes wheat. So Monsanto said, Monsanto, the makers of glyphosate, of Agent Orange, of napalm, DDT, and a host of other chemicals and poisons, weapons. They said back in the 70s and 80s, they wanted to be the world's largest food supplier. Hello? Are you listening to that? Or do you care? Most of you don't, because that's all you hear too. So we're trying to do the best we can with what we've got. Okay, I've got heirloom solutions for my that solar generator with the solar panel over there and such. And as a reward, I had 10 years of $100 worth of seeds, which stopped last year because, you know, they no longer do that no more. So, shame on me. But I've got enough for at least another 5 lifetimes. But this is just, I mean, we had a pack of maybe 25 seeds or 50 seeds, which they made the seed packages smaller too, like 10. Anyway, these are heirlooms, because heirlooms you can grow forever. You get the seed from your vegetable or a plant, and you can continually grow it forever. Buy crap from Monsanto and you buy it next year, and then you buy it the next year, and then you buy it the next year. You don't, some of them might grow half ass for one second year, but they're designed to not grow. Otherwise you're copywriting their material. It's all crap, folks. Again, you don't like my language? Tough shit. Go fuck yourself. Shut off the video. Otherwise, you know, I'm just giving you what's up. Trying to help people, tell them, explain, you know, stop eating the crap that's in the stores. It's not good for you. It's not good for you. Oh, ain't nothing happened yet, right? Oh, just the highest diabetes in the world, record of obesity, both things tied to sugar and starch. That's why I said, look on a loaf of bread. Does it say sugar, fructose, fructose, or any of those? It's all starch and sugar. You know, Yeah, I don't make things like they used to. 25, 30 years ago, they've changed. And now, that's what you have to try to avoid. But again, we've been very fairly fortunate to have this area where we can live here. Although the fact that it's surrounded by Monsanto, that's the major downside. But we have at least, my knee just popped. We still have at least this area here where we can, plant garden. So, all right, let me get to this. I'm going to stop recording and I'm going to start planting seeds down here and on the west end down there. I'm going to put all three seeds out. I'll put one, go about 4 to 6 inches, put another one, and then another one, 4 to 6 inches, and then repeat them like that all the way down. So, all right, and we'll see what happens. Let's see, it's April 11th. Let's see by the end of April if there's anything growing up out here. Okay, I would expect more than just that one over here, and if not, I'll plant one or two of these out here too. I'll just divide them up a little bit, spread them apart. As long as I got one right there, that gives me a marker, because I know if there's one right there, the other one was probably about there, and then one on the end, so I know about my spacing. I don't have anything specifically marked because, nature didn't intend it that way, so I just do it halfway with nature and halfway just, doing it. So anyway, that's it. Let me get these planted right there. Looks like one coming up too. I don't know if you can see it. I'm going to zoom in. The Sony might shut off. All right. I can just barely see it. It's not focusing. Right in the center there, it looks like a seed popping up. A plant popping up from the ground. Right in the center. Very center. But that's all. Enjoy yourself. China Mart's got it.